Hi, my name is Brandon. Do you know what surgery is? Surgery is when a doctor works inside your body while you're sleeping. It's a different kind of sleep, but we'll get to that. I had surgery once. The doctor put ear tubes in my ear to help me hear better. You can't see them. They're really, really tiny. Now, your family has a special book to tell them about surgery for kids, but what about you? It can feel scary anytime you don't know what is going to happen. That's why I'm going to tell you the 10 things you need to know about having surgery.
Why?
Food. You can't eat too close to your surgery time, so your mom or dad might give you a snack the night before. You see, during surgery, your whole body will take a special nap, including your stomach. So any food you've eaten needs to be out of there. After surgery, you'll get a treat. Bring stuff you love. Your mom or dad will help you pack a few of your favorite things, and that's good, because before and after surgery, it will be good to have things to do and to keep you busy. Sweet. On the day of your surgery, you'll arrive about an hour or so before surgery time to check in. And that brings us to...
three!
Get your band on. You'll get a hospital wristband. Or two. Some kids might get two or three. It'll have your name and birthday on it. People who work in the hospital will check your wristband a lot while you're there. And if you bring a special buddy, they'll give one to that little guy too. I brought my superhero. You know who else you'll bring to the hospital? Your parents. Parents rule! Your parents get to stay with you while you're getting ready for surgery and when you wake up. They even get special stickers so everyone knows they're there for you. If you stay overnight, your parent can even sleep in your room with you.
Five!
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 Getting ready. Getting ready for surgery is a little like a doctor's appointment. Just like at your doctor's office, after check-in, you'll sit in a waiting room. When it's your turn, a nurse will take you and your parents to the get-ready room. It's also called pre-op. The nurse will check your weight and height. Then they'll take your temperature. And check your blood pressure with that cuff that gives your arm a hug. A nurse will also put a pulse oximeter on your finger. It's just a bandage with a special red light attached. They call it a pulse ox for short, and it tells doctors and nurses how you're breathing while you're asleep. Some kids might get a few tests before surgery, like taking pictures of bones in your body, or peeing in a special cup. Actually, I gotta go. I'll be right back. Keep it clean. The next part of getting ready is kind of like getting ready for bed. First, you'll wash up. You won't take a bath, but you will clean up with the wipes the nurse will give you. She'll help you if you need it. Your team wants to keep everything very clean for your surgery, including you. That's why they wear their hospital PJs, gloves, hats, and masks. It's all about keeping germs out. Now, who is this person? The doctor who will do your surgery is called a surgeon. Did you know that on your surgery day, a lot of doctors and nurses will be there to take care of you, just like your parents? Got a question? Ask it. Have a worry? Share it. And if someone asks you, "How are you doing?" there is no wrong answer. Just say exactly how you feel. Rock your PJs. How cool is this? Wearing PJs during the day. You're going to look great in your hospital pajamas. Oh yeah, work it on that runway. Sorry, I got caught up in the moment a little. You guys rock. Anesthesia. Anesthesia is a big word that means special medicine that helps you sleep during surgery. The first step is getting some sleepy juice. It's a liquid medicine that'll help you feel relaxed. Next, it's time to meet the anesthesiologist. The anesthesiologist is the person who will give you medicine to help you sleep during the surgery. The anesthesiologist will also stop the medicine when your surgery is done and it's time for you to wake up. All you have to do is breathe in. Are you wondering what this medicine smells like? You get to choose the flavor. I chose orange, but you can choose the flavor that you like best. Sorry. When it's time for surgery, you'll have plenty of time to say, "See you later," to your family. Did you know your hospital bed has wheels? Your team will give you a ride down to the operating room. Here we go! Your family will be in the waiting room nearby. Your nurse will bring them in to see you when the surgery is done and you're ready in the recovery room. In the operating room, your nurse might put some stickers on your chest. They also have the masks with the medicine that fits on your nose and mouth. Remember the flavor you chose? Now is when you'll smell it in the mask. Your anesthesiologist will ask you to take deep breaths. Imagine you're blowing up a big balloon. Good job, you're asleep. The medicine you're breathing works so well, not even something like this could wake you up. And you won't feel anything during surgery either. Ow.
Nine.
Wake up time. The next thing you know, you'll be waking up in the recovery room after surgery. Yes, the recovery room. That means the surgery is done. The surgeon will talk to your mom and dad, and they will come back and stay with you in recovery until you go home. When you wake up, you might feel a little different. Some kids feel tired, sore, or their stomach might be a bit upset. You'll probably have a mask on your face. This time, it's just regular air to help you wake up. You also might have an IV on your arm or hand. An IV is a small straw connected to a plastic tube with lots of tape. An IV gives your body water or medicine to help you feel better. Your nurse will take it out before you go home and put a Band-Aid on the spot. Little by little, you'll start feeling more awake in the recovery room. Now is a good time to tell your nurse how you're feeling. If you don't feel good, your nurse might be able to give you something to help you feel better. Your nurse may show you a card with faces on it, and you can just point and tell her which one shows how you feel. Hey, if you're awake and feeling okay, it must be time for number 10 and that special treat. I wonder what it is. Get your treat. Number 10, finally. Did I hear somebody say icy? Usually after your surgery, you get a treat. Sometimes it's a popsicle, but this time it's a delicious icy. Yum, so refreshing. Oh, here you go. But take your time, drink slowly. Your stomach is still waking up. After recovery, some kids will go straight home to rest in their own bed. Other kids will spend the night in another part of the hospital and rest until they are ready to go home. Now you know 10 of the most important facts about having surgery. If you have any questions, remember to ask a parent or a member of your surgery team. They're there to help. And now, if you'll excuse me, it's time I had my icy. It's like a snowstorm of fabulous flavor. Oh no, brain freeze.